Today we're at Charter Excelsior Schools and we are about ready to install an 8x11 Aquascape Signature Series pond. My guys are just now rolling up with the excavator. Here they are, machine, truck, my crew. And here's what's going on. Today we're going to start by just making this thing really, really simple, because the day after tomorrow is a community pond build where we have all sorts of students and staff members coming in to help us gravel and rock this beautiful water feature in. And this is going to be a science lab for the school. So the cool thing about it is that as the students are coming into and leaving the school, they get to see the waterfall running, they get to see the pond running, and it's a really nice inviting environment right outside the main entrance. So this area is going to be transformed into a really cool Zen garden. And believe it or not, I got this project handed to me because of a clean out that I did 2.5 years ago, right at the beginning of COVID. Stay tuned for this video. It's going to be a fun one. Today's the day and we've got everything pretty much well started. We're at Excelsior Charter Schools over in Corona, California, and today's a build a pond day. We're putting in an outdoor science lab in for this school, and it's an awesome 8-foot by 11-foot aquascape ecosystem pond. And this pond has all the basics and all the benefits of a professionally built water feature. So here's what's going to happen. So far, as you can see behind me, the pond is already mostly rocked in. We're gonna put the waterfall together in about the next hour or so. And from that point forward, we just rock it, we plant it. The goal is to have all of this done, have the waterfall completed, and have it all planted and rocked in by 12 o'clock. That means that we've gotta have a bunch of people. So I've got Ian working with the kids on the, Ian's working with the students on getting the gravel inside the pond. I've got Jose, Tavo, and Joe working with me on the waterfall and on rock strapping and getting the big boulders put into place. And then I got Jenny from Nature's Waterscapes. She's also working with the students and getting the medium-sized rocks and getting all the plants put inside the pond. It's gonna be a fun, fun day today. And hopefully, we hit that goal. What do you think? Do you think we're going to hit it? Let's see. The pond is done, the pond is rinsed, and the only thing that's left to do right now is to eat some tacos and then come back after lunch and plant it up, give it its first clean out, and call it a day. We have probably maybe a half an hour, 45 minutes worth of work to do after lunch, which is great. This is a great place to stop. So we've already rinsed the pond out and it's filling up for its first run. And once it's done running, we're gonna pump all this water out, give it its first clean out. Those two tanks way over there, each one of them has 500 gallons worth of water, which is probably a lot more than this pond can handle. That's all filled up with fresh water. So after we dump this out, we're gonna get that on out of here. And then we're going to refill it with that and fire it up. And instead of leaving them with a muddy mess, we're leaving them with a beautiful crystal clear pond. Wait till you see the drops that we've got going in this waterfall. There's pinch points all over the place, rolling areas where the water just rolls and tumbles, and a few little falls. It's really going to be cool. With an Aquasurge 2,000, 4,000 gallon per hour pump, it's going to be super neat to see what it can do at low speed, intermediate, and even at high speed. Right now, it's time for me to go get some tacos. All right, lunch is over. The pond is great. The waterfall is running great. We're pumping it out right now. We're wrapping up its first clean out. Tanks are being refilled right now. And as you can see, we've got an army of students that are now planting this thing up and getting ready to throw mulch on top. And I'm kind of guessing that by the time I get done putting the retaining wall around the backside of the biofalls right over here and dressing up and hiding the biofalls from the front, I'm pretty sure that we might have maybe less than an hour to go, half an hour, 45 minutes to go. So we're jamming. School spirit is awesome. I absolutely love Excelsior Charter School. These guys are just off the charts. They have great spirit, they have great attitudes, they're working so hard, and I couldn't be happier, I couldn't be prouder to be a part of this project with such a great group of students. All right, and it's done. We're refilling the pond right now. Fresh water is coming in off the tanks, and it's picture time. So, it's down to just some finishing touches, hamming up for the shot, and hey, what a great crew, Excelsior, woo! All right, and everybody wants to see the water running. So here's the pond. It's a nice little 8x11. And the waterfall is really pretty. I want to show you guys this. Check this out. So I was just talking to Joe about this. And one of the things about waterfalls is that most people, they just have to feel that they have to do framing stone, spillway stone. But what I did differently in this is I did a whole lot of pinch point and rolling points. So check this out. Right over here, that's just a nice little pinch point, like it's rolling and it splashes down into those rocks down below. And Joe had the idea of putting together this really nice cooling area right here. So this is a pretty cool spot. So this is one stone here that has a crevice and it goes down. And this stone over here has a crevice and it goes down. And so the water kind of pours in between these notches, and it really looks like over nature it was just carved out and it was meant to be. Moving up to this next stone, this is a really cool one because this one is kind of blocking this next shelf, and it forces the water to come behind it and spill around and come down. But look, this is a rolling rock spillway. So the water is just rolling right over these rocks. Isn't that pretty? And then finally, up at the top, we found this one here that had a natural notch in it. So we have the water coming out of the biofalls, kicking out really nice and far off of this. We put some pennywort that's growing in over here and lots of other really great plantings inside this. And again, you can see there's a light right here. So at nighttime, this is just gonna illuminate. It's gonna be so pretty. So the whole community came together on this project, which was really fun. We had all these kids and teachers and administrators, and looks like we're gonna be doing more. I guess there's one of these coming up for us next in Redlands, and which is my hometown. I'm a Redlands High School graduate, class of 1988. And we've got another one in San Bernardino, which is also really cool. And imagine this. You're coming in, driving into school, and you see this beautiful pond and waterfall. And it actually looks good from all sides. Well, that's it for this video. If you came across my video for the first time by chance, or maybe if you're a student over here, an administrator, somebody that somehow, some way found our channel, hey, do me a favor. If you like this video, please subscribe. And if you want to ask any questions about this video, put your comments down below, because I respond to 100% of every single comment that is left on my YouTube channel. And in the meantime, I'm Carl with Columbia Water Gardens, and I'm here to, today, I'm not here to remind you of nothing. I'm just here to thank Excelsior Charter Schools for such a great turnout, great students, and a fantastic time. Happy ponding.